Jerome Kersey. Jack Neese will toss the ball in the air, and game five is underway. John Stockton matched again with Terry Porter. Porter with that bruised quadricep, the upper left leg, and it's heavily bandaged. Carl Malone with Buck Williams, Blue Edwards, and Jerome Kersey. And Edwards drive and jam. First pass to the ball game for the Utah Jazz. Jerome Kersey.
A push off the ball. Jeff Malone inside trying to keep Drexler away from the rebound. So Portland will get another possession. You see the scowl on Jeff Malone's face. Not happy with the call.
Clyde Drexler averaging 10.3 rebounds and 10 assists a game in this series, plus more than 19 points.
When you play a team as often as Portland and Utah have played in a short series, nothing really changes except the execution. You want to try to do what you do best, better than your opponent. You know that Utah wants a slow game. The Trailblazers want a quick one.
Opening minute of play at Portland Memorial Coliseum, 628 consecutive sellout. Stockton to Edwards, steal Jerome Kersey. Knocked away by Malone, Jerome regained. Fight, score Jerome. 4-2, Blazers lead.
Eaton never had a chance to react. Once Kersey initially got the step behind him, it was clear sailing to the hoop. They're coming back looking for Carl Malone.
Malone doesn't deliver, and Kevin Duckworth coming off of a 30-point, 11-rebound game as his first rebound of the night. Big Duck. Porter by Stockton. The open Duckworth. Portland 6.
He's probably the best 15-foot jump shooter in center in the league.
6-2 Portland. Stockton left side. Up top to Blue. Turn. Jump it up and in. Blue Edwards has both Jazz baskets. A first to driving Duck and now a jump shot down the barrel. 6-4. Portland with a lead. Porter. Wide left to Jerome Kersey. Blue with a hand check. No harm, no foul. Kersey holds. Now he'll fake and drive base left. Blue for the ride. Gets the foul. What a hand check. That'll be his first Jazz second team foul. Portland ball. Waddell inbound, front court, left side.
Jerome Kersey, who proved that he can drive to the basket both ways, left and right.
Blue, loop it up, won't go, he's fouled. Great move out of Stronger. Blue Edwards, second foul, the Jazz third. Kersey shoots two, and Thurl Bailey. A check in here quickly for Blue Edwards.
That's two quick fouls there by Blue after getting off to a good start, making the Jazz first 4 points. Take himself out of the basketball game because of a couple of fouls.
Portland's 3 out of 4 from the field. Jazz 2 for 3. Out of 8 to 4, Portland with the lead. Stockton to the front court straight away. Giant up top, holds and looks. Stockton, right side angle to Big T. He'll go to the base. One bounce, leap and lean. They block it, they foul it. Bailey shoots two. Foul Duckworth. Now that's Portland's first team foul. And Thurl Bailey, who has made 13 out of 15 against Portland in the playoffs, will shoot two.
You know, Duckworth just steps out, gets in the Jazz off and running. They tried to score up.
Porter comes out and lobs it way over the head of Buck Williams and out of bounds. Jazz ball on a chance to take the lead.
So he rubs his hands on his jersey. Call that a slip.
Jeff Malone will handle the ball. Jeff to the front court left side. Clyde Drexler with him. Wide left to Big T. Bailey down low to Carl Malone. Great position. Turn in and score the layup. Carl Malone underneath.
I tell you why he had great position. If we ever get a chance to see that again, John Stockton said the best pick of the playoffs for Carl Malone.
Down low right. Duckworth for the ball. Jazz are up. Duck takes him underneath. He slams it in. Beautiful play. Kevin Duckworth.
There's a move we haven't seen a lot of from Kevin Duckworth in the playoffs. He wheeled around Mark Eaton. Slam dunk it.
Four tied at 10. Stockton down the left side. Stock down low to Thurl Bailey. He'll fake right, turn left, try to go up, knocked away by Kersey and out of bounds. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Utah. Waddell inbound underneath with Carl Malone to handle the honors. Jazz line up 2 under 2 out. They'll scissor off, looking for Jeff Malone. He's got him base left, follow away 50-footer, in and out, and back in. Good, Jeff Malone.
A lot of mileage out of the same out-of-bounds play there for the Utah Jazz. Usually ends up with Jeff Malone knocking down that 10-footer.
Drexler down low right side of Duckworth. Duck back for the hoop. Down the middle. Beautiful feed. Drexler scores. Count it. They probably. Boy, you can throw it a tank through there. No one near the play. And then Karl Malone moved in to pick up his first foul.
Well, and once Jeff Malone double team was giving Mark Eaton some help on Kevin Duckworth. Glide to glide.
Jeff drives, gets by Drexler, but if they knock it away, Jeff saves it back to Stockton. 3-point country right side. Duckworth really on a mismatch. Low to Eaton, a little left hook. Good. Mark Eaton from John Stockton.
Smart play by John, taking his time, taking advantage of the mismatch.
Front court. Here's Buck Williams up top. Jazz with a 1-point lead. Buck holds. Karl Malone with him. Wide right. They'll go again to Jerry Porter. Porter checked by Stockton. Porter back to mid along the baseline right side. Porter making, turning. Now before the shot, a 3-second lane violation called against Jerome Kersey. Jazz ball.
Jerry Porter knows he's a lot stronger than John Stockton. He was trying to take his time, back John in towards 5 feet from the basket and try to shoot over him. Jerome Kersey just in a little too hurry to get the offensive rebound.
So the Jazz with the ball and a 1-point lead. Karl Malone left side, out of time deep. Mark holding and looking to Stockton again. Stock drive the middle. Right side angle to Bailey. Leaping lean, underhand scoop, roll, going round and out. Rebound Duckworth. A good effort by Bailey, but the shot wouldn't go down. Here's Terry Porter, spinning in the paint. Eaton there to help. Up top to Duckworth. Duck has it knocked away by Eaton, but he gets it back. Duckworth lives it low left. Into Buck Williams. Across the middle of Karl Malone. Slip it over to Duckworth. Duck on a base. Turn. Bailey knocks it away. Duckworth saves it, but it goes to Karl Malone. And Karl steps out of bounds. Portland ball.
Great defense on the line on the play.
For a good play, and then the mailman's foot right on the line.
All the Blazers starters now in the scorebook. All of Utah's starters have scored at least a field goal, and it's Portland by one. Karl Malone spins out. Second tough roll for the Jazz. Bailey had one. And let's take a look at Karl Malone and Buck Williams.
Anytime you get these two players, you get some contact, and that was a light contact right there. Their bodies have been colliding the entire series.
Thurl Bailey, given the outside shot, and gets this one. Thurl Bailey.
That's the only way Bailey's going to get out of the funk is to continue to look to the basket. That's one of his shots, and he's got to take it when it's there. Squeeze the ball inside.
Kersey re-enter on the pass, but we have a foul.
Drexler pushed off in order to get possession of the basketball.
It is Clyde's first. 14 fouls on Utah, one on the Blazers. And there you see the final score as Chicago closes out Philadelphia. Sixers were down 10 going to the final quarter. Made a run, but the Bulls win it 4-1. Jeff Malone. Soft shooter's touch. Malone had a number of those in game four, and it's 18-15, Jazz by three. Three-second violation called by Daryl Gerritsen. And, Steve, we've had two calls in the opening quarter, and those are the first three-second calls I can recall in the series. Five turnovers already for Portland. The Jazz have made two. Stockton is down, now up. Karl Malone powers inside and floats it home.
Jazz right now have a good rhythm at the offensive end, and the Trailblazers are going to have to apply a little bit more pressure. Drexler rebound.
Can't score. Drexler again. Lost the ball in traffic. Karl Malone is down with it. Whistle and a foul. It's Clyde Drexler called for a trip, a pull down.
Drexler goes in, changes hands, can't get it, beats everyone back to it. Now you'll see them go up, and on the way down, just a little bit of contact. Daryl Gerritsen interpreted that as a trip, so Clyde picks up his second personal foul.
Clyde tried to turn the low hurdles into the high hurdles.
Now this is where the Trailblazers have to come out and establish themselves at the defensive end. The Jazz beginning to build a little confidence at their end of the floor that they can do what they want. They get a foul against Jerome Kersey, trying to body throw Bailey off the bucket.
The second half. Stockton's drive. Rebound off to Portland. Drexler outlet to Terry Porter. Has Kersey and Williams behind him. Clutch shot. Offensive foul.
Turnovers here hurt the Trailblazers as they were scoring on almost every possession. Buck Williams decides to try to come over and through Thurl Bailey, picks up the charge.
And as you saw, Bailey had solid both feet down position. Jazz leading by five. 4 minutes to go, first quarter. Jeff Malone, steal, Terry Porter. Blazers in transition. Kersey. Tried to hit Buck Williams on his right.
A little bit too
it.
Deep with that pass, and sometimes they can be guilty of overpassing, and that's what happened on that possession. Buck Williams was open, but the pass was going to have to be too quick, too hard for him to handle to get through the defense.
Seven Blazer turnovers in the opening 8 minutes of play. And Steve Portland's averaged less than 12 turnovers a ball game in this series.
That means they can only make four more. They got a lot of time left yet to play. Eaton right hand.
Fighting to beat the 24-second clock, but the ball draws no iron, and the 24-second violation gives the Blazers the ball with 3:25 in the first quarter.
Well, Portland had four straight possessions, no score. They need a hoop.
20-15. Blazers down five. Again looking for the cutter, and again Utah doing a better job of trying to stop that play by getting a hand in the passing lane.
They're doing a better job of reacting to the cutter, so they're staying between their man and the hoop, which is the first rule of defense. Know where your man is, be aware of where the basket is, and at all times you'll have a chance to it.
Illegal defense called on Utah.
Being a little bit too unselfish.
Drexler and Malone. Line. Yes. 5 points for Clyde Drexler. Blazers draw within three, and we move inside 3 minutes to go in the first period. Stockton with a shot clock at 10. Around Malone. Thurl Bailey. Rebound, finally to Buck Williams. Porter down the lane and draws the foul. I think Thurl Bailey, yes. Terry Porter can bring the Blazers within one. And does. It is 20-19 with 2:25 to go in the first quarter. Ball in the hands of Spokane, Washington native John Stockton. Bailey with Robinson. Eaton to Bailey, and Bailey powers it home.
That's the kind of play that will get him off track. I don't think you have to worry about Mark Eaton scoring, so you don't have to double on him. That puts pressure on the cutter, and Bailey made him pay.
With a shot clock at 10. The Jazz called for illegal defense. Duckworth.
Williams, low post right. Across the alley on Mike Brown. Back from the angle left to Cliff Robinson. The jumper too long. Rebound to Mark Eaton. He'll go quickly to John Stockton. Stock front court straight away. He'll take right drive. Back to by Porter and score it. Stock. This second field goal and a dandy of a move.
You know, John has left Terry Porter in this series standing in his tracks many times because of the crossover dribble going to his left. I think he plays John to go right.
Duckworth takes it down low to Mike Williams. Across the middle. The hook by Buck is up and wild. Rebound Mike Brown. Right hands to Stockton. Stock with 4 points and three assists. John straight away. Now he'll angle right. Porter right with him. Stockton again going to the half-court game. As the Jazz lead 24-20 here in the opening quarter. To the angle left. Jeff Malone. 15-footer. Rebound Duckworth. Quickly to Terry Porter. Porter pushes it up. Porter straight away. Snap it over on the angle left to Drexler. He'll put up a three. That's up and over the backboard and out of bounds. Jazz basketball with 53 seconds left in the quarter.
You have to have strong legs and good range to shoot a flat foot three-point jump shot. And that's just the shot that he just took in. That's awfully tough to make.
Mark Bryant in for the right in and out. Rebound, Mark Bryant. Quickly to Terry Porter. Porter across the midcourt line, takes a three-pointer. That's no good. Rebound right back to Porter. Porter to the angle left. Cross court right to Duckworth. Duck goes base right to Mark Bryant. Checked by Mike Brown. Out front out of Drexler. Clyde drive the baseline right. Mike Brown there to help. And Bailey steals the pass. Bailey quickly to Stockton. 17 seconds left in the quarter. Stockton down the middle. Now John will back it out. The Jazz will play for the last shot of the quarter. 10 seconds remaining. Utah with a 24-20 lead. Stockton to the angle right. 5 seconds. Stockton with three to Bailey. Left side. Take it. He's too late. Roy, why did he take that? Good. We go to the second quarter. Terry Porter with 7 points. Danny Ainge has checked in for Portland. Jazz have Karl Malone back in there with Bailey, Mike Brown, Blue Edwards at a guard with Stockton. Stockton, cross court left to Blue. Jazz lead 24-22. They look to Karl Malone and Ainge knocks it away and out of bounds. Jazz ball. As Ainge kicked it, the Jazz get a fresh 24 seconds on the shot clock.
Well, once the passer, Blue Edwards, Terry Porter, once they pick the basketball up, they're backing up into the passing lane. The Jazz shooting 61%, 44 for the Blazers, and rebounding just about the same, 5-8. 3 turnovers for the Jazz, 8 for the Blazers.
All right, Stockton with the ball up top. In a paint to Blue, back to Stock, swing left. We'll go to Bailey, he'll cross the middle, running hook, wide of the mark. Rebound, Danny Ainge. Ainge, front court. Danny Ainge straight away, he'll go right side angle to Terry Porter. Porter holding, the stock running down low to Duckworth. Duck backs in on Mike Brown. Turn around, he was so surprised he missed it. As he was wide open. Mark Brown, rebound Mike, Karl Malone. He'll lay it over to Stockton. Stockton across the court, he'll veer right to the right corner of the Blue. Again to stop, swing left to Big T. Earl Bailey. One bounce, down low to Karl Malone. The mailman jumps a 15-footer. It's good. Karl Malone, his third bucket, 6 points in the game.
You know, with Mark Bryant guarding Karl Malone, look for him to go to the basket.
Porter, all the way. Hit all the layup. Terry Porter, driving off to the right side, went right in for the layup. And he has scored 9.
That definitely should not happen, especially where he started driving from, almost at midcourt.
Left side, Karl Malone, Jazz by 2. 26-24, Utah. Karl. With the ball, Stockton's knocked down underneath, and we got a foul. That'll be charged to Terry Porter. That's his first. Now Portland's first of the quarter.
You know, I think this is a call that this was not a good call here. John is looking for the leverage to lean on, and he ended up falling on the floor, and that was the reason Terry Porter was a little upset.
All right, Bailey into John Stockton. Stockton straight away. Jazz again working that half-court game to the left corner to Bailey. Bailey hands back to Stockton. He'll clear out. They look into Karl Malone. Stock holding. He's got it if he wants it. Stock now takes a load of Karl. Across the middle. Force it up. It's good. What an incredible shot. And no foul call. That's 8 points for the mailman. He's hit 4 out of 6 shots.
Mark Bryant trying to fool Dale Garrickson.
Here's Porter. Left side, Danny Ainge alone. 15-footer. No good. Karl Malone up for the rebound. Baseball strike to Stockton. He's down the left side. Stockton fake left, go right. Taylor to Karl Malone, open from 20, the shot, yes! Karl Malone from John Stockton. The mailman scored 6 straight points here in the second quarter. Ainge base right, he'll go underneath to the angle left to Terry Porter. Porter, leap and lean, Stock fouls him over the top.
How smart Terry Porter was, he knew John Stockton would own.
30-26 Utah. Stockton directing traffic. Karl Malone will come out and set the screen. Stock fake right, go left. He'll roll to the mailman. What a beautiful pass. Jumper up, no good. Blue Edwards almost got it on a missed judge. Rebound, then a foul. Against Utah, on the rebound, the loose ball foul, Mike Brown.
Well, Blue Edwards just mistimed this missed shot, but he was up in the air long enough to almost tap that in. It just shows his jumping ability.
Walter Davis checks in for the Trailblazers. He'll be guarded by Blue Edwards. Danny Ainge with the ball. Swing left to Davis. Back to Danny Ainge. Underneath there's Duckworth. Good position on Mike Brown. But he'll pass it to Robinson who runs right down the middle. Now they caught a foul. Now the Trailblazers, Jazz ball. 30-27, Utah with the lead. Blaster midcourt, Jeff Pannone. That foul was to Stockton, his second. That's why he's out of the lineup right here. Jeff Pannone with the ball, wide left to Blue. They're looking into Carl. Can't find him. Back to Jeff Pannone. Now low to Carl. We got a whistle. Behind block. Julio and Bill Hall. Carl still holding the screen. Now Jeff double pumps. Goes back to Blue. And he travels. Jeff Pannone, the travel call. Ainge, right side front court. Manny, right to left. Down goes Jeff Pannone. Ainge all alone. Jumper's good.
Danny Ainge got his foot tangled up with Buck Williams as he was trying to go over the top of the pick.
So Blue Edwards with the ball. Jazz by one. Blue straight away. Blue Edwards down low right to Mike Brown to the right corner to Blue. Blue raises 20-footer. Yes, out of the right corner, Blue Edwards.
What a big basket there by Blue. Quieting the crowd down. They're trying to get involved in this game.
That's 3 for 3 for Blue. Ainge for three. Yes!
That'll get them involved. Danny Ainge is one of the premier three-point shooters in the league at this time. The crowd's involved now.
Score tied at 32. Ainge with 5. Blue Edwards with the ball straight away. Blue snaps to Jeff Pannone. Angled out. 17-footer. Got it. Jeff Pannone with 3 field goals. 6 points in the game. Jeff continues to shoot well. He's 3 out of 4. Danny Ainge front court. Danny right to left. Danny down the middle. Great feed under the wall to Davis. He'll back it out. Face right. The shot no good. Rebound. Tipped up. Grab by Carl Malone. He'll hold and hand to Jeff Pannone. So Jeff front court. He'll hand back to Blue Edwards. 34-32 Jazz. 7 minutes left in the half. Blue down low right to Mike Brown. Spin across the middle. They take it away from him. Mike Brown over to Danny Ainge. Ainge front court left side. He'll drive. He'll go to the hoop. Shot no good. He's fouled. Ainge going in left. Foul. Charge to Blue Edwards. His third. Fourth team foul in Utah. On Ainge shaking up on the play as Mike Brown really clobbered him coming in hard. Danny hit the deck.
Well, he was hit pretty hard a couple of occasions there, but the blow was from Mike Brown as he was in the air as he attempted to make the shot.
So we got a timeout. 6 minutes and 49 seconds left in the opening half. Danny Ainge is up and all right.
Utah Jazz 34, 6:45 to play first half. Live action from Portland's Memorial Coliseum. Shot clock at 8. Stockton inside Mike Brown. Tap on Mark Eaton and it goes. Second basket for Mark Eaton, Utah by 2.
Ainge has been very aggressive in looking at the basket. That was a good opportunity, but he's putting a lot of pressure on John Stockton defensively.
Rebounds even at 10 apiece. Score favoring the Jazz by 2.
If they have advantages right here with Stockton against Ainge, and Ainge has a tough time really keeping the penetration away. Rebound Davis.
And Portland now, as we go past the halfway mark of the second quarter, a chance to tie. Cliff Robinson.
Good decision by Cliff, but the ball was a little short.
Walt Davis. Ball knocked out of bounds by Robinson, Utah possession. 5:40 left, second quarter.
Now this is a real strange front line the Jazz have. Brown, Eaton, and Malone. None of them really good passers as Ainge just pulled John Stockton to the ground on that drive.
Clyde Drexler will come back in for the turn by Stockton. He has 6 points, Utah leading by 4.
He squeezed the pass inside to Danny Ainge. He was right there at the hoop but couldn't control his balance, so the ball ended up being kicked by him.
Drexler.
Now you can see why John Stockton gets knocked down a lot. Not only on his initial screen does he set, but then when the player tries to move around him, he moves and sets again. That's where he usually takes a shot. They get a call against Buck Williams, his second. Fourth team.
Both teams with 14 fouls in the quarter. So from here on in, we move to the penalty. Malone to fade the score. the best off-balance shooters in the league. Utah back up by six, but Williams scores and draws the foul. Mark Eaton getting the foul. It is his first of the night.
A quick hitting play in transition surprises Eaton and the Jazz. Buck Williams extends.
By 4:40 left, first half. Jazz still shooting very well from the field, 62%, as we get a whistle from Jack Neese and a technical foul called on Clyde Drexler. And that came well off the ball, Steve, as Mike Brown comes out for Utah.
All of the Jazz to work further out on the perimeter. Utah's been able to get deeper out on in their offense. Right at the iron. Jeff Malone.
And Malone now with 6 in the quarter and 10 in the ball game. He has made 5 of 6 shots. Jazz by 8. Kevin Duckworth. Malone to Stockton. Jeff Malone. Hot hand, and the Jazz find him. Malone has made all 4 10 points. 3:50 to go. Drexler deep and scores. 7 for Clyde, his first field goal of the quarter. Let's see if the Jazz take it back through a red-hot Jeff Malone. Whistle prior to the shot. 3 second violation, the Jazz. 46-38 Utah. The Jazz shooting 65% from the field and the Blazers 43.
Well, that was a play that won the game for him, and it was there, but he couldn't handle it. Drexler trying to squeeze it in. Stockton knocks it away.
Stockton finds Malone. Jeff shot. This time, no Thurl Bailey. Offensive rebound and stick back. Thurl Bailey with 8 points. His best start of any game in this series. Clyde Drexler. 9 for Clyde. The Utah lead is 8. 2:50 to play, first half.
Now, what Portland needs in that 2:50 is a discouraging defense. We haven't seen it yet. The Jazz have been able to operate at their end of the floor with a good deal of freedom, movement of the ball and people. Thurl Bailey knocked away.
Stolen by Drexler. Porter. Score it. Portland within 6. Porter, 8 in the quarter and 13 in the game.
Offensive foul, Thurl Bailey.
Thurl Bailey
was not lucky.
Coming up on 2 minutes left to play in the opening half. Kevin Duckworth with Mark Eaton. Block, good help, Carl Malone, and Eaton gets the ball to Jeff Malone. Bailey puts it home. And Thurl Bailey, who had shot 31% in this series, has 10 points tonight, has made 4 of 7 shots. Jazz by 8. Whistle.
Thurl Bailey.
Portland has beaten Utah 6 straight times here at the Coliseum. Jeff Malone had that baseline spot he likes, but in backcourt, Carl Malone, Buck Williams.
Buck Williams trying to stay in the game.
Jeff Malone with Danny Ainge. Carl Malone won't go. Rebound up to Danny Ainge. Blazers down five. Porter. Duckworth. Three-point game. 1 minute to play. 20-second timeout, Utah.
Stockton with the ball. Stock straight away. Stockton up top. Holding and looking. He'll go to Jeff Malone, the angle left. They double him up. Jeff holding. Back to Stockton. 7 seconds for a shot. And Stockton is out of bounds. Portland ball. They call an offensive foul on Stockton. That's his third.
Jeff Malone will replace John Stockton for the last, Delaney Rudd replaced John Stockton for the last 39 seconds of the half.
All right, here's Danny Ainge with the ball. Ainge, front court left. Danny Ainge. Portland now will play 2-for-1. They go to Duckworth. Here's a shot. That's no good. Rebound, strong. Lucy. Jazz by one. 50-49. Delaney Rudd with the ball. Portland should get the last shot. Right, looking inside. He almost throws it away to Ainge. Not a good pass at all.
Yeah, no ball fake there because Danny Ainge was in full stride. He tried to time that pass very perfectly.
Power Malone to inbound. The mailman with 10 points, 5 out of 10, 5 out of 9 shots. Here's Rudd. Delaney faking, drive the middle. He'll go underneath to Mike Brown. Slammed up. Big Daddy. That's 4 points for Mike Brown. 8 seconds left. Here's Terry Porter. Jazz lead by three. Porter, drive right, pull up. 16-footer, no good. Rebound, grabbed away. And scored by Buck Williams. Incredible shot. As Rudd fires from backcourt, he was knocked to the floor. And no foul call. Daryl Garrett is standing right on the call. Does not make it. Jerry Sloan comes all the way out on the floor, but no call made. Where are we here?
The hoop for an easy two. Terry Porter was very aggressive in attacking John Stockton, forcing him to play some defense and perhaps tiring Stockton as this game wears on. Porter with an excellent first two periods of play, 5 in the first, 8 in the second quarter of play. Ainge came out with the same aggressive posture against John Stockton, buried the three-point opportunity, and that shot tied the ball game up. Jeff Malone was the story for the Jazz in the second quarter. 8 points, and one of those right at the iron. But Malone is able to shoot at odd angles, but the reason that he is so true is his shoulders are always square to the hoop, and he knocks another one down. Stockton, again in transition. You see him looking around to find out who's with him. Finally, creates the penetration. Jeff Malone down on the baseline. At that point in the ball game, it looked as though the Jazz were on a roll and the Trailblazers might have to go in down a deficit. Drexler back with a quick jump shot of his own. Defense has been the difference for the Trailblazers when they've been able to get out and run. They force a steal. Drexler forcing a tempo, pushes it. A quick pass to Terry Porter, extends to the hoop for two more. But the Jazz have kept the Trailblazer running opportunities to a few. Good penetration and surprising penetration by Delaney Rudd and a thundering two-hand effort by Mike Brown. Porter with the rebound, and you see after the rebound the contact and the exchange between Buck Williams and Karl Malone. And Buck Williams wanting Karl Malone to know that he's not going to have any of the play in which he's going to be intimidated, and that's what that was really all about. Duckworth misses his shot. Jerome Kersey showing you the strength and tenacity on the offensive rebound, rips it away from Jeff Malone and scores two more for Portland. Quick shot at the basket by Terry Porter. The ball is deflected. Buck Williams never comes down and gets it against the clock. The last scoring play of the half. Let's see if good, hard, clean, aggressive play will prevail. And Portland certainly needs a quick pass in to Kersey. Ball knocked away.
There are 13 seconds left on the shot clock. We are just underway in the third quarter. Portland leading, or Portland trailing by one. And the question now is, why aren't the shot clock and the game clock exactly in sync? But it's just a fraction of a second, so here we go. It is Clyde for three. Blazers take the lead. 54-52. That is the Blazers' second three-point shot of the night. Utah does not have a three-point field goal. Jeff Malone. Rebound, Buck Williams. Blazers looking to continue the spurt that closed the second quarter.
Now Clyde was trying to squeeze it in, got off balance, and that puts the Jazz in an early transition.
Blue Edwards for Paul Malone. Can't finish the shot. Buck Williams rebound. Porter, hard push. Too deep against Eaton's defense, but the ball off Utah and belongs to Portland.
The crowd came here waiting for an explosion. They've yet to see it, but that's the kind of play that will get them on their feet. A good, aggressive attempt by Terry Porter.
Porter, three-point try. Yes. 16 for Terry Porter, and the Blazers lead by five. And Utah takes a quick 20-second timeout.
Stockton wide left, Carl Malone the screen, Stockton behind him. Stockton terminates, cross court to Blue. Blue Edwards, one bounce, Grace from 18, it's around and out. Rebound, Clyde Drexler to Terry Porter. Porter gets past Stockton, Eaton there to help. Underneath, right side, now back out to Kersey, driving and fouls him hard. Down goes Kersey. Eaton the foul.
Ron Kersey driving strong there. He turns his back to Carl and into Mark Eaton, and they were going to give.
They're going to give Mike Flagler a foul.
A flagrant foul there tonight. Now, Daryl Garrison did not make the call, but he was the official that was talking to.
One more for Kersey. And that's good. So he has 9 points. Portland up 59-52. They scored 8 straight points and they got the ball. We played only a minute and 39 seconds. Drexler, the Porter out front. Cross court up top to Kersey, to the angle right. Drexler out alone. Another good one.
Oh, boy.
That's 14 for Drexler. 61-52, Portland. Here is Jeff Malone to the front court left. Wide left to Blue Edwards. Blue holding. Left corner Stockton. Underneath, there's Carl Malone. The ball hit the rim, and it ricocheted out of bounds.
Boy,
Portland ball.
What happened?
Porter. Porter down the middle. Porter, penetrate left. He'll go to the base. Leap and lean. Shot up. No good. Rebound. Porter. Eaton is there to intimidate him, and he dribbles out to the right corner. Terry Porter. He'll yo-yo wide right. He'll raise 20-footer. No good. Rebound. Buck Williams. He'll go back to Kersey left side. Now to Clyde Drexler. Drexler down low to Duckworth. Duckworth across the middle. Feeds back up top to Kersey. To base right. Drexler to follow him. Up on the rim. Tipped up by Kersey. No good. Rebound. Kersey. Yes.
And there's the second shot opportunity for the Portland Trail Blazers. They are red hot at the beginning of this third quarter. Now the Jazz will take a full timeout.
12 straight points by the Portland Trail Blazers. And we played only 2 minutes and 44 seconds, 53-52. Portland with a lead. Stock straight away. Doctor, yo-yoing up top. He'll spin it right side of Big T. Bailey. Burrow, jump one from 12, around and out. Rebound, Buck Williams. Over to Terry Porter. Porter to the angle right to Clyde Drexler. Drexler live back to Porter, base left. He'll go by Stock, double pump, shot up, hits, no good. Eaton tips it up in the air, and Bailey grabs it. Earl Bader, then he drops it, picks it up again. Over to Jeff Malone, down the left side of Stockton. Stockton backs it out. He'll look in, he'll go low to Carl Malone, lay it up, won't go. Rebound, Jerome Kersey. over to Terry Porter. Porter drive the middle. Drive it baseline.
And there it is again. Penetrate. Look. You penetrate. You look to kick it out to a jump shooter. This time it was Buck Williams going to the basket.
65-52. Portland. The Jazz have not scored a point in this third quarter. Stockton to Jeff Malone on the angle left. The Trailblazers rolling. They have scored 13 unanswered points. Illegal defense on Jerome Kersey for Portland. They have left Bailey way over to the right side. Well, at least that stops the the crowd for a moment. All right, Bailey to inbound. Bailey, right side. He'll go to Stockton. Stock straight away. Stockton drive off to the angle right. Base right open. Thurl Bailey. Mr. Bailey. Rebound. Porter. Porter front court. Porter down the middle. Porter to Drexler. Side holding. Down on the right corner. He'll go to Kersey. Buck Williams the screen. Kersey right to left. Kersey spins it back to Clyde. To Clyde in the right corner. He'll drive the base. Jeff Malone trying to stay with him. Clyde. Jack Knight move. And Eaton reaching in. Fouls him on a pass off. So for Mark Eaton, his fourth. Two team fouls in the quarter against the Jazz.
They're having a subpar shooting night in the first half. The Portland Trailblazers have come out in the third quarter very hot. They shot 47%, but it wasn't very pretty.
Ball comes into Clyde Drexler. He's straight away. Got it behind Jeff Malone. Fly to glide. Right side angle to Terry Porter. He'll go to the base. Got to get away. He'll back it out. Now cut right to left. Down the middle to Duckworth. Double pump. Makes one bounce. He's open. The shot up and in.
And then Duckworth trying 15. To kick up in this third quarter where he left off in game four.
16 straight points by the Trailblazers. Base left. Bailey gets it. Or Jeff Malone. The shot is good. Jeff Malone finally ends the drought. The Jazz first points in almost 5 minutes of play. Porter comes back. Score another one. Terry Porter, a 15-footer. 69-54. Trailblazers rolling. Down the left side, John Stockton. Cross court, Carl all alone. The banker, good. Nice feed by Stock. Carl with 12 points. He's made 6 out of 12 shots. Stockton with 10 assists. Right here is Porter with the ball. A 13-point lead for Portland. Up top, Buck Williams. Down low, left to go to Drexler. Glide to glide. Fake left to right. Leap and lean. Shuffle. Now won't go. Rebound tipped over, and Bailey's got it. Down court is Stockton, but the late getting to him. Out of stock. Pitch court right side. Stockton bounce it out. Stockton will veer left. Stockton looking in to the mailman again. Buck Williams fighting in for position to go low to Clown. He's got it. Turn in. Shot no good. No foul called. Ball loose on the floor. And they caught a jump ball. Final.
And Thurl Bailey getting down on the floor trying to get the basketball. Tied up by Jerome Kersey, who incidentally jumped center at the beginning of the basketball game. He's a very quick jumper. As Karl Malone tries to power his way into the basket. And there was a no call.
Bailey, the jump with Kersey. Kersey should get the tip. He's been jumping center all along. He goes up quickly and got the tip, but he jumped too quick. I would think that'd be Jazz ball.
He stole the tap then. Oh, boy.
They're going to make him jump again?
Yeah.
That should have been Jazz ball. Now to go up again. Bailey gets the slap over, and it's picked up down there by Terry Porter. Porter down the left side of Drexler to Duckworth. Base left. 10-footer. Up goes it. Rebound, Thurl Bailey. Over quickly to John Stockton. Stock front court. Stockton up top. Stutter step move raised from 15. He scores it. Stockton with 8 points. Porter comes back for Portland. 69-58 Trailblazers. Porter drive the base. Underneath it. Eaton covers him like a blanket. Baseline right to Duck. Pass down the middle. Knocked down by Stockton. Almost picked off. Duckworth gets back to Porter. To Duckworth. Foul Bailey. Duckworth going in strong. Thurl Bailey with 4.
Jazz playing some good defense in that sequence there. Just couldn't come up with the loose ball. And now they put themselves in a mismatch situation as Thurl just takes it right to Kevin Duckworth, who weighs 270 pounds and very hard to knock to the floor.
Mike Brown will check in a moment. 70-58 Portland. John down the left side with the ball. Stockton Again, looks to Carl. And again, Buck Williams right on his back. Push and match continues. And now they finally call the foul. On Buck Williams, here's third. First foul of the quarter on Portland. So Carl Malone will inbound. Front court left side. All right, he'll go into Mike Brown. Mike will hand back to Stockton. Stockton veers off right side. Stock cross court left to Jeff Malone. The jumper from 17 up on the rim. No good. Mike Brown tips it up and in. Nice follow-up. Mike with 6 points. 70-60. Trailblazers. Gary Porter straight away. Cross court left to Clyde to Glad. Open for three. This one no good. Rebound. Buck Williams. Right back to Porter. Low to Duckworth. Duckworth back to the hoop. Eaton with a forearm on his back. Duck across the middle. Left hook up around and out. Rebound. Carl Malone had it, and the Trailblazers knock it out of bounds. Drexler, the last man to touch it, Jazz ball.
You know, this is not a bad lineup the Jazz have on the court right now if they can keep the Portland Trailblazers from running, because Mike Brown will go to the offensive board.
Stockton down the right side. He'll go to Jeff Malone. Jeff fakes left, go right. Floated up on the line. It's good. Beautiful move. He had him thinking he was going to go left off the Carl Malone screen. He came back strong to the base right.
Every possession on either end of the floor, there's someone that ends up on the floor.
Kerry Porter down the left side of Clyde Drexler. He'll go to the base left. On Jeff, all on for the ride, and they call the foul. That's Jeff's second. Jazz fourth. That'll be Portland's ball. 4 minutes and 14 seconds left in the third quarter. Portland up. Here's the steal by Stockton. All the way for the layup. It's good. John Stockton, he has 10 points, and give him another steal.
The Jazz patiently fight their way back into this basketball game after getting off to a really a slow start at the beginning of the third.
70-64, Trailblazers. Drexler drive the middle. Jump is good. The ball kicked out of bounds by the Jazz. Or who? Yes, they'll get Portland first time. Chevron is the one stop that has it all, Jazz fans. At Chevron, we're with you all the way. Well, we got a timeout taken by the Trailblazers. Portland with 27.
3:51, and the next foul will get them in the penalty. Quarters wide open.
Kersey, offensive rebound again for the Blazers. Terry for three. Eaton slaps it up in the air, but Williams has it again.
Three chances usually hurt you. We'll see if the Trailblazers can make them pay. Kersey.
In the quarter and 13 in the game for Jerome. Blazers now with four in double figures, led by Porter's 18, Drexler's 16. Portland by eight.
And again, the crowd trying to get into it. Carl Malone.
14 for Carl Malone. Offensive rebounds. Portland 13, Utah 3. Duck buries it. Portland shooting in this quarter has been just outstanding. Blazers by eight. 2:45 left third quarter. Stockton throws it away. Lucky to get it back. Shot clock at eight.
That ball has bounced around John Stockton like he's got a magnet on. He's looking at the clock trying to get inside. Tough floater. Beat the clock. Got the rebound.
And Mike Brown finally tracks it down.
Look. Drexler ended up on the floor, and that melee pops out.
Carl Malone gets the tough roll. Fourth time tonight, Utah has had a heartbreaking bounce up on the iron. That is the 10th rebound for Buck Williams. Kersey splits the defense, draws the foul. Mike Brown.
And that's excellent basketball by the Trailblazers. When the double team came, they got the ball to a man with the seam to come down the lane, put some pressure.
6 point game.
They start with the screen across, but they're going to come get Carl Malone. He doesn't take the screen.
And missed the easy jumper. Buck Williams, rebound number 11. Five. offensive rebound to Robinson and score under pressure. First field goal of the night for Cliff. Blazers lead by 10. 1:15 left, third quarter. Jeff Malone. Rebound Drexler. Robinson. Blazers by a dozen. Final minute, third quarter.
You can't let Stockton come right up like this and get a quick shot. Even though they're beginning to show some signs of fatigue, you got to continue to keep the pressure on Stockton. Inside, block, foul.
The foul is on Danny Ainge. It is his second. Blazers' first team foul.
To do all the right things with so few people is beginning to catch up with him. Drexler trying to go inside. Quick pass, and it's right over Danny Ainge's head.
Delaney Rudd will come in for the Jazz. Stockton, a quick rest. We remind you, our telecast presented by Authority, the Portland Trail Blazers, solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any rebroadcast, reproduction, or any other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Trailblazers is prohibited. Mike Brown, defense collapses, and the ball stripped away and knocked out of bounds, shot clock at 14.
The Trailblazers know not to take Mike Brown for granted, so they triple him, forcing him to try to make a pass. They'll get the ball back with 11 on the shot clock.
Delaney Rudd for three. Leaves it short, gets the offensive rebound. Only
there have been few mistakes by the Trailblazers at that end in terms of shots allowed. Rudd chased that ball down, going for penetration.
Off-balance shot. Offensive rebound. Brown cannot beat the buzzer. Third quarter is over. They're on their feet in Portland. 12 minutes to play, and Portland leads Utah by 10.
Very few. And that's to keep them from making the big plays mean the offensive rebounds and the three-point shot that usually get this team rolling.
All right, Stockton, front court, right side. We go to the fourth. He'll go low to Karl Malone. Good position. Turn in, missed the layup. That is a foul. Cliff Robinson.
Yeah, but
should have made this shot, don't you think? Look at this. He's absolutely wide open there. Just threw it way up too hard.
I don't know if the bump by Cliff Robinson really threw the shot off or what, but he did miss it badly.
Karl Malone shoots seven. Important. Danny Ainge, everybody hops front court left. Stockton picks up on Danny.
Oh,
Ainge had that big second quarter. We had 7 points, including the three-pointer. Underneath the Drexler to Robinson. Right down the middle. 7 points for Cliff Robinson.
Like Drexler is an excellent passer. He's an excellent jumper, excellent shooter. That's the reason he's an all-star player.
80-70. Portland, and we got bodies tangled up inside, and Cliff Robinson gets another foul.
You know, what made that play, Thurl Bailey gave up there for a second, let the official see that there was their arms was tangled, then he fought like he was trying to get it loose, he forced the call.
All right, Stockton, here's right. Stockton on the yo-yo, pulls up, he'll bounce it to the angle right to Carl, the shot looks good, it is good, the mailman. That's 18 for Karl Malone. Stockton with 13 assists. Quickly, Danny Ainge, front court. To Cliff Robinson down low. Back to Jerome Kersey. Again to Clyde Drexler. Robinson low right. Foul, Karl Malone. Shot won't go. Shooter Robinson felt contact. He let it go.
As he had every intention of shooting a jump shot anyway, as he started to the middle, Carl bellies up, and then Cliff, smart enough, just to follow through with his intention, shoot the jump shot, and
the rebound of Brown. Back to Robinson. Free throw line, jump it up. Shot around and out this time. Bailey rebounds, they take it away from him. What a foul. Percy had it, but Percy commits the foul. Percy's second foul. Portland with three team fouls.
You can see why this team is so effective rebounding. This team eats glass, as coaches would say. He's a glass eater. This team is a glass eater.
Front court left, Stockton with the ball. John Stockton looking in to Karl Malone. Up top to Bailey, back to Stockton on the left wing. John looks to Karl Malone, can't find him, Stockton up top. Stockton keeping a dribble alive, bounces inside of Mike Brown. He's got it, the ball away, no. He passes down low to Karl Malone, kicking away by Jerome Kersey. over to Drexler. Here comes Portland to Danny Ainge. Underneath the basket, Cliff Robinson, the turnaround, no good. Rebound, Drexler. He's shoved in the back. He'll shoot two. Five Drexler. Foul by Mike Brown. His third. Jazz second team foul.
Jazz overpassing on the other end. Cliff Robinson had an excellent chance to score there. He missed a great opportunity. There's a little shove in the back by Mike Brown as the rebound was from Clyde Drexler.
Free throw good by Clyde. And Drexler, five rebounds and four assists in this game. Front court left, Jeff Malone. Wide left for Pearl Bates. Portland up 83-72. Pass comes in, down go the bodies. Danny Ainge gets the deck with Carmelo, and we got a foul against Portland. Charge to Mark Bryant.
Mark Bryant really pushed Carmelo into Danny Ainge, who was in front of him a little.
That's the fourth team foul of Portland. Jazz ball. 9 minutes and 55 up top. Right side angle to John Stockton. Looking for help. Cross court left to Jeff Malone. Jeff holding, low to big team, good position, across the middle, little hook, they foul him, Thurl shoots two. And a foul to Jerome Kersey, his third. Portland's in the penalty.
You know, all players, and Jerome Kersey was guilty of it this time, has the arms straight out in the air, he's reaching, he's not moving his feet. Good defense, good shooters, smart players will take that ball right underneath their arm and draw the foul.
Bailey's free throw, good. Thurl with 11 points. That's his first point in the second half. Bailey, 4 out of 9 from the field. 3 for 3 from the free throw line. 4 rebounds. 2 assists. Second free throw, good. But T has 12.
That shot barely buckles the net. He gets the basketball up in the air very high, and it's a soft shot.
83-74. Portland with the lead and the ball. Danny Ainge to Drexler. Down low, inside Cliff Robinson in the paint, the turnaround up the rim, no good. Drexler for the rebound. Great play to Ainge, open, angle left, shot good.
Not very hard to box out. You know, Clyde Drexler goes to the boards, you have to box him out.
So Danny Ainge with 9 points. Stockton down the left side. Stockton looking into Thurl Bailey, Drexler clutching. Stock holding. Now to Thurl, they double him up. Bailey has a cross court to Crown below, and the mailman powers to the alley. Ainge blocks his pass and goes down. He'll get the foul. That's three on Ainge. Carl Malone shoots two, but it's a little late.
Well, and Carl really goes hard to the basket here. I mean, he goes in very strong. Danny Ainge leaning in. He was caught trying to get position there on Carl Malone, but Carl went to the basket very, very strong.
85-76 Portland. Ainge. Tiffany hops left side. Stock along for the round. Stockton with a hand check. Ainge under the Drexler. We got a holding foul before the shot by Jeff Malone.
Jeff has
had him in good position.
Well, he has to fight Drexler a little harder on that. That's just giving him too good a position. He's not fighting him at all. Just got to get all the way around in front of him if you have to.
Third team foul on Utah. Portland will put it in play right side. Clyde Drexler turns it in to Danny Ainge. Right about a stop. Up top, Drexler. He'll fake left to right. Pirouetti's in the paint. Over on the base left, they'll go to Kersey. Open from 16 out. The shot no good. The rebound, Jeff Malone. Quickly to stop. Stock with a head up. Stock front court right side. Down takes the 16-foot jumper. It's good. That's 14 for Stock. 85-78.
Only took three shots in the first half.
Here's Cliff Robinson. He'll alley-oop to Drexler. He got it off the glass. Scored it.
That's an old school shot play there. Bank it off the glass. If your man has the inside position, just eye contact, you'll make that play.
87-78. Portland with a lead. Jeff Malone, right side. Out front to Stockton. Stockton drives the middle. He'll go back to the mailman. Open from 16. No good. Rebound knocked out of bounds. The last touch by Jerome Kersey, Jazz ball. Terry Porter and Buck Williams back in. Going out, Mark Bryant by Jerome Kersey. Danny Ainge. He's got him in the paint. Leap and lean. 10-footer, got it. Jeff Malone with 18 in the game. On 9 field goals. 87-80. Portland with the lead. Jazz hanging in. Porter to Drexler. Underneath, great feet. Buck Williams.
Perfectly timed. Perfectly timed. You wrap around the pick, you keep the man on your back, and then you have numbers. You have to be picked up.
89-80. Portland. Right side, Jeff Malone. Power to screen. Jeff right to left. Cross court left. Stockton. 4-3. Stock shot. Yes! John Stockton with 17 as he's carrying the Jazz here in the late going. 89-83. Portland. Terry Porter. With a ball away and down low. We got a whistle. Offense on Cliff Robinson. I believe.
That's what it's on.
Nine holes. He'll go right side of Paley. Thurl drives low to Eaton. Mark has to flag it down in the right corner. Eaton holds on. Out front. Throws it over Porter. Terry Porter. Down the left side. Trailer. Drexler. Slammed up.
Mark Eaton, who was smothered there by Kevin Duckworth, did not get the clear shot to mark to John Stockton, and now the Jazz call a timeout.
6 minutes and 44 seconds left in the game. Drexler has 20 for the Portland Trailblazers. They lead 91-83.
A hustle play by Mark Eaton turns out to be a huge swing. He hustled to save the ball and then passed it right to Terry Porter.
Jeff Malone, open for the shot, doesn't have the angle. Well off to the left, and here comes Clyde. Portland leading by 8. Almost halfway through the fourth quarter.
Duckworth wants a chance again against Eaton. Now, if he takes his time like he did last time, he'll get a shot. Looped it.
And Thurl Bailey rebounded. Stockton, stop and go move. And the foul will be called, I think, Kevin. No, Terry Porter. It is only his second foul. But, again, penalty situation, they'll shoot two.
Stockton electing to go on his own because he saw his team, and Stockton's very good at making that decision. Team is struggling.
Six-point game. Halfway through the fourth and final quarter, 6 minutes to play. Robinson and Bailey. Left. Aggressive move to the basket, draws the foul. Thurl Bailey, it is his fifth personal foul. Fourth team foul on the Jazz. Cliff Robinson has quite an arsenal of offensive moves inside, doesn't he?
But Cliff has got a very good inside game, and it's just a question of establishing.
93-85, as you see, 8-point game. Game clock on your screen. Stockton and Porter looking at each other again. Offensive foul. Thurl Bailey, he's fouled out of the ball game.
Well, you learn some things along the way. Cliff has been called for some. This time he drew one as he came down, knowing that he and Thurl Bailey.
93-85, Portland. Thurl fouling out with a dozen points. Clyde. Right there with a great look, but it wouldn't fall. Utah again will try and close to within six. Jeff Malone. Spins inside. Tough shot, it goes. 20 points for Jeff Malone, who's averaged more than 22 per game in this series. 93-87 at the five-minute mark.
Well, you see why they got Jeff Malone, because he's able to score the basketball. Coming back the other way, they're going to get a foul against Blue Edwards. Blue is looking around. He can't believe the night that he's had, but he has not been able to stay in the basketball game because he picks up these quick fouls.
Portland by 7, 4:50 left. Shot clock at 10. Stockton to Carl Malone. Malone with 8 in the quarter, 22 in the game. The margin is only 5. And the pressure builds here at the Coliseum. Jerome.
Now they triples, that means someone's going to be open. Percy comes underneath, can't get the call.
Mark Eaton rips it away, and then a foul on Jerome trying to get it back.
Now they triple, and Kersey spins away from it. Thought he was going to be able to get the foul. Eaton blocked it up top. That was one of those that could have been a no call.
Portland by 3. 4 minutes and 10 seconds left in the game. Terry Porter, front court left, down low to Drexler. Glide to glide, front of a Jeff Malone. Drexler backs him in. Drexler still dribbling. Eaton there to help. Tide shoots it up for low to the backboard. And it's hit. It hit the bottom of the rim. He had no forward position. And Jeff Pinnell comes down with the ball. Down to the left side, Stockton. Stockton wide left. Stockton over the left corner. He'll go to Jeff Pinnell. Low to Carl. Far away, 12-footer, no good. Eaton tips it out to Blue. Jazz with fresh time. Blue Edwards, hands to Eaton. Now out front to Stockton. 3.5 minutes left in this game. 15 seconds on the shot clock for the Jazz. Low to Carl Malone, base left, shot blocked from behind. Drexler comes down with the ball. Over to Terry Porter. Trailblazers slow it down. Porter, pretty angle left. He'll go again to Drexler. He'll bounce under the Porter.
What a
Terry
pass.
Porter.
Excellent pass there by Clyde Drexler. Bounce pass to Terry Porter. That was almost the same play that won game two.
A 5-point lead. The Jazz take a timeout. Terry Porter with 20 points. Drexler also with 20. 3:04 remaining.
So everybody is coming to him. That means if you go to the hoop, someone's going to be available. The player, Terry Porter.
Jazz 12. Here is Jeff Malone. Front court left. Clyde Drexler with it. Jeff on the yo-yo. Coming in. Right inside. We got a foul, and it's going against Portland. Carl Malone shooting out. He's 6-for-6.
That's where Portland feels this is a big possession for them.
Porter behind Duckworth. Right to left. Go to the alley. He'll shove underneath. Kersey drops it, and it's an offensive foul on Portland.
Very good call.
On Terry Porter.
Very good position there by Blue Edwards with it. Positioned himself right in the middle of the paint. Terry Porter's momentum carries him right into to Blue Edwards as he tries to split two defenders. There's Blue, great position.
Stockton to the front court left. A 3-point Portland lead. John Stockton. Boy, these games have been outstanding here. Right corner to go to Blue. Out front to Jeff on the angle right. Eat the screen. Jeff right to left. Jeff Pinnell, pull up. 17-footer, no good. Rebound, Kersey. Kersey over to Terry Porter. Porter walks about half dribble, front court left. Stockton with him. Porter wide left to Clyde Drexler. Drexler holds on. Duckworth the screen. Drexler beats Jeff. Base left. Shot for Goody. And it ricochets over to Stockton. Now to Carl Malone. Back to Stockton. Stockton down the right side to Jeff Malone. Out front to Stockton again. We got 1 minute and 50 seconds left in this game. 96-93 Portland. Stockton left to right. Right side of Jeff. Open. 16-footer. No good. Wide open. He missed it. And Carl Malone fouls. Oh, my goodness. That could have been a 4-point play right here.
Yeah, that was an effort that Carl Malone, I think, had to do. You have to try to get the offensive rebound there.
But this shot wide open by Jeff. He missed. Carl goes after it. And they get him with a foul. Drexler shoots two.
And that was a big possession there for the Jazz, obviously.
That makes him more. 22 for Drexler. 98-93 Portland. Stockton down the left side. Stockton looking inside for Carl Malone. John looks. He'll go base left to Carl. The off-balance jumper, no good. We got a foul.
And not a smart foul either. That was a bad foul there on the veteran Buck Williams. And he knows that's a no-no. Why foul? Stopping the clock, giving the Jazz a chance to score with the clock stop. This is something they don't want in this situation.
12 fouls on Portland in the fourth quarter. Carl Malone shoots two. 1 minute, 28 seconds left in the game. 98-93, Portland with the lead. The mailman with 10 of the fourth quarter. With the right hand. It's good. 26 for Carl Malone. All right, it's 98-95 Portland. Terry Porter, front court left. Jazz hanging in there. Wide left to Clyde Drexler. Duckworth the screen. Clyde left to right. Trailer. Druck Williams. Beth Williams, he has 12 in the game. 100-95 Portland. Stockton, front court left. Stockton drives the base. Running east, out front to Eaton. Back to Carl Malone. The mailman, 18-footer from the angle left. No good. Blue tips, won't go. Porter for the rebound. Terry Porter, front court left. Now the Trailblazers using the clock. Left side angle to Drexler. 10 seconds for a shot. Clyde left to right in the paint. Go in the hook, force it up wildly. Goes in.
Great call, but what a great shot there made by Clyde Drexler.
Offensive foul.
And it was an offensive foul, but what a shot that was just made, giving the Jazz another opportunity to get a little closer and win this game.
Clyde Drexler, I'll tell you, man, he does not play well in a half-court slowdown game. Forces the ball, as he did here, and he's done it before.
They'll take it any way that they can get it, and what Portland has to do is make them work for it.
40 seconds to play. The Blazers leading by five. That's how far Portland is away. The quick release by Stockton. It was a two-point try. Drexler the rebound. The foul by Mark Eaton. And Clyde could just about lock this one away with 32 seconds left.
In one of those situations where they did come looking for the quick tray, and Stockton got a good look. Terry Porter back off just enough for him to get the ball in the air. Drexler was there to get the rebound. Eaton, knowing they got to stop the clock, puts the bear hug on him.
Clyde missed the free throw, but he's been marvelous again tonight. Half a minute to go. Jazz down five. They've got to rush the ball up the floor. Blazers trap. Steal Drexler. Porter fouled. And will go to the line and shoot two, but now only 20 seconds remain.
Drexler upset with himself about missing the free throws, comes back with a big defensive play, gives Porter a chance for a three-point play. He can't get that ball to roll in. It skims off, and he will step to the line with a chance to push the Blazer lead to 6 or 7. You see the Blazer bench. They're up right now. The crowd beginning to chant, beat L.A. They don't know what the score is down in L.A.
Portland by 6. Last goal we had from L.A. was the Warriors leading by 7 late third quarter. If it is Portland in L.A., they'll start here on Saturday, assuming the Lakers series does not go 7 games. That would be a 12:30 game televised on NBC. Porter makes it, and that should lock it up. 7-point lead, 20 seconds left. Utah calls their final timeout, and the fans here
lobs it into Delaney Rudd. Rudd hurries right side. He'll back it out and take a three. Drexler fouls it.
And there it is again.
That's another bad play.
And we were just talking about that, how he hurts the team sometimes down the stretch by making not making smart plays.
So Drexler with his fifth foul and on the line. Now Porter. Here's Terry Porter. Left side, Kersey. 8 seconds left. Kersey throws it up, won't go, a foul. The game is over. Portland has won the game. They win it by 7, and they're on their way to play the winner of the Lakers Golden State Series for the Western Conference Championship. Portland wins it 4-1. The final score here, Portland 103, the Utah Jazz 96. We'll be back with a recap